Hey guys, I want to answer a question. Why do I have insulin resistance but normal A1C? I had a client ask me this, so I'm just going to do a video on it. First of all, what is insulin resistance? It's a pre-diabetic state, okay? It's something that comes before diabetes. It's a situation where you're having higher amounts of insulin because insulin is not working, okay? So then the body makes more. So that's what that is. And then A1C is a test to diagnose diabetes. And A1C is an average test, an average of 3 months of your blood sugar. So it's more reliable than just one blood sugar test. So A1C should be like in the like high fours, fives, low fives, but when it gets into higher fives, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and then you have a serious blood sugar, you're already a diabetic. So that's how they diagnose it. But check this out. You first get insulin resistance, okay, then it converts into a type 2 diabetes, which is the first stage where you're actually officially have problems with your blood sugar. Now, here's the thing. It takes 10 years for this to develop in some cases. Sometimes it's a lot shorter, but in a lot of cases, it's 10 years. So you may test it in the transition phase where it's subclinical. It doesn't show up on your blood sugars yet. So, of course, it's not going to show up in the A1C yet, because it hasn't affected your blood sugars necessarily. The insulin is high, but it hasn't done anything with the blood sugars yet, okay? So one test that you could do for insulin resistance, and I'll do a specific video on this, is a fasting insulin test, not a fasting glucose test. And that way you can pick this up a lot better. But what happens, you got insulin resistance, type 2, and even type 2 can turn it into a type 1 where there's no more insulin. However, there are other causes of type 1. There is also a genetic type. It's also autoimmune, triggered by stress. Okay, but if you take a type 2 over a period of time, if you notice a lot of type 2s, they start on metformin, and then all of a sudden they need more insulin, and more insulin, and more insulin. Why? Because their cells that produce insulin are wearing out over time. And then to the point where all of a sudden they don't produce any insulin, and they would be officially categorized as a type 1. Type 1 just doesn't produce any more insulin. Okay, the cells are exhausted. Okay, so this is the kind of the cycle of worsening of blood sugar. So I hope that answered this question, and put your comments below. Thanks for watching. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. Please click the subscribe button, and I will see you in the next video.